Christ the Lord, never try. If only you know what possibilities he can prophesy. And I talk to the church now. They are here four realms of prophecy in the church in the apostolic faith. Number one, you have the scriptural prophecy. Number two, you have the gift of prophecy. The gift of prophecy does not make you a prophet. Lord have mercy. The gift of prophecy, amen, prophecy is a gift given to you by the Holy Ghost to build up the church, to edify the church, to comfort the church, and to equip the church. Can I talk to you tonight? And then you have the spirit of prophecy. Don't ask me. You have the spirit of prophecy. What is the spirit of prophecy? The spirit of prophecy can come on any person at a given moment. Can I talk to you here? When you start worshiping God, when you start to praise God, the gift of prophecy can release upon an individual, and they can stand up and begin to prophesy, and that does not make them a prophet. And I call to it here. So some of you have the spirit of prophecy. You don't have to be here. Stay a long time. If the spirit of prophecy choose to come upon anybody, it can stand up and speak what's on God's mind. Somebody clap your hands and shout hallelujah. Glory to God. The spirit of prophecy is great over worship. And worship is intimacy. It's not everybody can worship God. Worship is relationship. There's a story behind your worship. There's pain behind your worship. Let me know what I'm saying. You've got to have a flashback. Look back over your life. And look where God has brought you from. And then you start to praise him. And then you praise him. You step over into worship. Somebody say worship. I worship and we worship God when they don't have no music, because they came out at the turnings of affliction. They've been through hell and they're still standing. Somebody clap your hands and shout hallelujah. I feel the Holy Ghost in this church tonight. You've got to let the devil know I am a worshiper. Somebody clap your hands and shout hallelujah. Glory to God. Have a seat if you can. You're scaring the visitors. And all that mercy. And that's why not only the members should worship, but the pastors, the leaders should worship. Can I talk to you here? That's why before you were a pastor, you was a worshiper. God always called worshipers. Can I talk to the church tonight? Glory to God. And the next apostolic release is restoration. Somebody show restoration. Somebody show revival. A revival is coming. I said a revival is coming. I said a revival is coming. But it's not coming back to a dead church. A sick church. A weak church. We come from fire baptized church. Revival is coming. Restoration is coming. And in the last day, said God, Jesus, every Holy Ghost.
seed in Japan, the spirit in the visitor church, and the next apostolic release is a wave of glory. Somebody show glory. Lord have mercy. There's a new wave of glory that are about to hit the apostolic church and release a seven levels of anointing. Somebody clap your hands. Glory to God. Have a seat in your hand. Let's talk a little bit. There are several levels of the anointing. Somebody look at some of the several levels. Glory to God. All you know is about one level. Glory, there are several levels to the anointing. Level number one is the anointing in the first level of authority. Level number two is the anointing in giftings and calling. Level number three, the anointing over nations. Level number four, anointing over demonic princes. Lord have mercy. Level number five, anointing over territories. Lord have mercy. Because every region and every territory, there are demonic princes that are a stronghold over that territory. So before you come here and you leave New Jersey, you better know what kind of prince demon that have a stronghold in this neighborhood. Because if you're a soldier in the army of the Lord and you have an assignment, you've got to know what kind of devil you are fighting against. And I perceive in my spirit that there's some witches in here, some warlords, and some opium. But I come